Good evening, everyone. I'm glad to be here to present the Citizens Charter. Is actually last year we conducted series of workshops as Dr. Pradarshini Karve just said that as part of the Sustainability Smart Project we kind of had lot of interactions with the citizens of Pune through lot of collaborations with the NGOs and organizations, then individuals, and with the help of them we could organize workshops to understand what is the role of citizens and to get citizens' perspectives, as she rightly mentioned. So I will just go through this the work that we did in the last year and also seeing the city from sustainable development goals. I'm sure most of you are aware of sustainable development goals, but here I'll just give you a quick information, just a brief information about sustainable development goals, and especially this SDG 11, which talks about cities, making cities sustainable from that perspective. So yeah, so just a quick info, sustainable development goals actually they were adopted by the United Nations in 2015, and it was all the most of the countries who are part of the United Nations, they accepted these goals. So there are around 17 goals, and each goal each goal has certain targets. So in total there are 169 targets, and under each target we have certain indicators to measure if the target is fulfilled or not. So these goals are supposed to be achieved by all of us by 2030. So India has also adopted these goals, and we are supposed to adhere to this framework. And in India, Niti Aayog is the agency who is working on these goals, and they are working in collaboration with the Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation. So they are developing national level indicators for all the SDGs, and they have also come up with the SDG India Index. So we are right now in the process of reviewing that, but these indexes are at the national level. To work at a city level or at a state level, there's nothing has been defined as yet. So also from that perspective, and to look at what is a sustainable city, SDGs give a very good framework, and especially SDG 11 gives a very good framework. So we thought of looking at SDG 11 specifically and the targets under SDG 11 and see what's the status of Pune with respect to the targets. So as I just said, that we are here only focusing on SDG 11 to start with. So under SDG 11 we have these four principles, or you can say pillars of SDG 11 that say that a city should be inclusive, it should be safe, it should be sustainable and resilient. So what does it mean by inclusive, safe, resilient and sustainable? So for all, whatever a city has, it should include all the socioeconomic classes, sections of the society. Then they should provide equal access, equal opportunity should be available for all the caste, there should not be any gender bias. And also it should include people with who are differently abled. So nowadays these things are we can see a lot of educational institutes or organizations having a special access for people who are differently abled. So and that is somewhere part of inclusivity. So that's about inclusive. Safe is, as we all know, we need safety from all kind of crimes, all kind of disasters, epidemics. So the city should also be safe. Sustainable here is about prioritizing local resources and minimizing waste and pollution. and about protecting our heritage. Resilient is all about making this like being prepared if like being keeping yourself prepared in case if a disaster occurs, like the way you recover back, the amount of the time that you recover back from any disaster. So you should have that kind of, you know, capacity to recover earlier. So these are the four pillars of SDG 11, and based on these, we are looking at all the targets of SDG 11. So these are the seven targets of SDG 11. The first target is about providing safe and affordable housing. So we have certain indicators for that, and the status of Pune we'll see it in the next slide. Then we have affordable, accessible transport, so that each of us can use the public transport. Then we have participatory governance, where the role of citizens should participate in all the decision making, like should have a place where they have a say in the decision making. Then of course we have to protect our cultural and natural heritage, and disaster preparedness. As I mentioned, that in this era where we have a lot of climate change impacts, and the disasters are not looked from that perspective as well. So this is just to also include that parameter. Then minimizing environmental impacts. So minimizing environmental impacts is here it is all focused on waste minimization and minimizing air pollution. And the last is about having safe green public spaces. Actually, we have a lot of green areas, but sometimes they are not safe, or many a times we don't have a lot of open spaces where people can interact, or it is also part of quality of life. So these are the seven targets under SDG 11. And so under each target, we have certain indicators. And as I said, that we don't have city level indicators defined by the UN or the Ministry of Statistics. But what we tried to do here is we tried to see if it is for a city, then what all we can take. So in Pune, we have something called a service level benchmarks for each services that is provided to us. So based on those, we kind of took those as indicators. Then we also have standards, the MPCB standards. So, and considering all this at a city level, what is the status of Pune when we look at SDG 11? So we came up with these numbers. So under affordable housing for all, the indicator given by UN says that you should have zero slums in the city. Like city urban slums should be zero. We don't need slums in the city. That's what it says. And all the everybody should have access to basic services. So, and in the case of Pune, says that we have 40% slums in Pune. I think you cannot see that. Is it, can you see that? Yeah, okay. Sorry, you can see. Okay, so in case of Pune, if we see in the number of slums, that is 40% slums, and basic services. So basic services are not, we all know that a lot of slums in Pune don't really get the basic services. We have some slums which are registered and which are non-registered. So the ones which are not registered, they don't have access to all the basic services, even like drinking water or regular drinking water supply or drainage facility. They don't have even waste management system. They don't have these services. Under inclusive transport, we have taken the benchmark, these benchmark from a comprehensive mobility plan of Pune, where it should be that share of PT is public transport, that 50% of the citizens should use public transport. and NMT is non-motorized transport. That is about that is using a bicycle or walking if possible. So almost 40 to 45% people should prefer NMT. But in case of Pune, it has been observed that only 18% of the people use public transport, while 33% people in Pune do prefer using a bicycle or walking or do walk. So under citizens' participation, as I mentioned that for participatory governance, citizens' participation is important, and it should be like all the citizens should get a chance to participate. But in Pune, we have a system, but again, the like we are not sure how that system works, because when we interacted with a lot of people, it was like they don't even know that such a system exists, where they can give their feedback as well for any decision making in the city. Then about cultural and natural heritage, I would like to say here that under cultural and natural heritage, the natural heritage actually talks about the rivers and hills that we have. Like in case of Pune, these are our natural heritage and they should be protected as well. While we have a heritage cell in Pune, like the indicator says that you should have a municipal budget. Budget should be allotted for heritage, for preserving heritage. So in Pune, we do have a heritage cell, but it is focused on only preserving the cultural heritage. They don't really look at the natural heritage, which is rivers and hills. So a lot of, but in Pune, we are fortunate that we have a lot of citizen groups and organizations who are actually helping preserve the natural heritage. And one of our speakers will be talking about that. So, disaster management. So in disaster management, what we saw that in Pune, again, we have a disaster management cell. However, and we have ward-wise disaster management plans, which were made, I think, long back in 2005. And after that, nothing has been done. Or people don't even know about these plans exist and how do they, you know, work. So the problem is we have the system, but nobody knows about this. Under environmental impact, as I said that we are looking at only waste management and air pollution. So under waste management, obvious that we should collect 100% of the waste and dispose all the 100% waste. And under air quality, we have air quality good measures. So as per MPCB, we have this air quality indices, which says that if the air quality index is between 0 to 50, the air quality in the city is good. But in case of Pune, for waste management, only 53% of the waste is actually collected. That is door-to-door collection. That is only door-to-door collection. And all that waste is 100% disposed. So remaining 50% waste is not even collected, and that's why it's not even disposed. So that's a tricky part there. And about air quality indices, as I said, the air quality index in Pune is 126, which says that we have a very poor air quality, as per the MPCB reports. The Maharashtra Pollution Control Board reports. Under safe green spaces, so here this indicator is actually the UN indicator. We don't have a Pune city, as I said, and even national indicator we don't have. When I was reviewing the national indicators list, it says that per person green area should be, you know, more than nine square meters, but in Pune we cannot really calculate that. So we saw that what is the green area available in the city compared to the total built up area. So we have more green areas, but here the problem is the green areas that we have tree species which are non-native, so they don't really contribute to the biodiversity part of it. Though it is green, so again there is a scope for improvement there. So this was the status of Pune for SDG 11 specifically. So last year when we took these workshops, we we discussed all these with like with the citizens and gathered their inputs that now that we know the status, what should we do, what can be done as like what people think should be done for all these targets. And we looked at all the three targets from inclusive, safe, resilient and sustainable point of view. And these are like, sorry for the bad image, but these are the inputs, these are the ways in which we collected inputs. And you must have received a handout outside while registering. So there we have the tables in which all the citizens' inputs are compiled as to like what should go under inclusive, what should go under safe, sustainable and resilient. So these are the compilation. This is the compilation. This is sustainable, resilient. Okay. And given now that we know what all should be done, we thought that why not ask people that what actions as an individual we can take in order, like what is in our hands that we can do to ensure like to make our city sustainable. So we want to come up with an action agenda. Of course, we have a scope where we can also review these. Right now, we are looking at only four priority areas. As you can see in the handout, we are talking only about four targets. That is transport, heritage, disaster management, and waste environmental impacts. So only those four we have taken as priority as of now. And all the inputs that we have collected from citizens last year, those we can still have more inputs on that. It that document also can be reviewed and modified. We can have more additions to that. Meanwhile, what we thought is, as I told you, an action agenda where what as an individual we can do. So under these four priority areas, these are some of the actions that as an individual we can do. So and we want to create or make a document where these individual actions can be documented and given to everybody. So we came like in the workshops we also came across with people who say that we want to do something but we don't know what we want to do and we also don't know where we should go. So we are in a process of creating this platform where people can have access. They know what they can get to know what they can do and then where they can go. This kind of platform we are trying to create. So one such initiative is we are working with Swachh, like where they are documenting what would be the, like if you want to, how you, like for managing waste, the wet waste can be managed in certain manner and the dry waste can be like managed in a certain manner. So but how to do that and where to go for that, so that we are just compiling that document. That will also be like in the coming months we'll be compiling that as well. And so here what we expect is that we want your help to create like give your inputs on individual actions that can be done to and also the citizens charter. Like you can review the entire document and give your inputs, individual as well as the whole. As even ma'am explained that at an individual level we can do certain things and at a policy level we can do certain things. So you please like I request you to give your inputs. So these are just some sample actions. Should I read those? Okay. They are ready, right? Okay. Yeah, and these are just, okay. So these are just some photos of the workshops that we conducted last year. We conducted total 8 workshops and so 2 we could conduct with colleges, college students, Bharati Vidyapeeth Architecture College and Environmental Science College. And other 6 workshops we conducted with Jivit Nadi, one with Jivit Nadi, one with Jivida, then with Parisar and one with Ecological Society. So these are the images of our workshops. And yeah, and that's it. You can give your inputs, you can email me, or we also have a Facebook page where you can like, subscribe and give your inputs. And also we have a blog. A weekly blog, you can give your comments on that as well. Yeah, and lastly, yeah, we create this is because we believe that power of the people is more stronger than the people in power. Yeah, okay. Thank you, that's it. I think I'm done.